Het is toch wel iemand met de kamin. Dit is de Taichung Temple. Het is gebouwd bij Run Zuyan of de Ming Dynasty. There is a Lao Tzu statue. Maybe this is why the dog is here. Yeah, you've seen me doing the dragon thing, right? Yeah. As a Taoist, I'm of course a religious person. As a scientist, I try to be as agnostic as possible. In the process of, creating these movies and making my travels and doing my, religious things, I come across, of course, a lot of places, and one of the places where I, of course, frequently come, that is the Wudang Mountains. I lived there for 15 years, off and on, also living in Wuhan, living in Beijing, Shanghai the last few years, before I went back to the Netherlands to create a more safe environment for my kids. These things are in outside the place, which you see here. Every time when I go to the Wudang Mountains, I have time to reflect on a lot of different kind of things, and I try to make recordings so that I can explain to you a little bit more about what these things mean to me. These things are in outside the place, which you see here. And this video is about my visit to a small temple on my way down from Jingding, the Gold Peak Mountain, to... These things are in outside the place, which you see here. When I came here in this temple, I was coming from Jingding downwards, and this is a small temple, and it is called the Laozhen Temple. There are a few of them from different dynasties, from the Tang, from the Song, from the Ming, and the Ming Dynasty temples have mostly been renovated because of being World Heritage material, and the ones from the Tang and the Song are not so much renovated. But also not all the Ming Dynasty temples have been renovated. This one that you see in this video has been not renovated, or with minimum amount of effort anyway, but it is on the way, so a lot of people pass by there. It is occupied by people of whom it is not exactly certain how religious they are. They're not necessarily monks. They may be monks sometimes, but not all the time. In so far, in the times that I were, that was there, there were a few times there were monks, but this time there wasn't. There was a female caretaker, and there was a male caretaker, and as it is with Hermitage, especially in tourist areas, it quickly becomes a way of living to earn income, and then of course the donations of the temple, they are part of the income.
These things are in outside the place, which you see here.
All the great names in Taoism, they had as one of their things the building or restoring of temples. Likewise, they also built roads, they do infrastructure projects, they planted trees, they do all kinds of things to basically benefit society as a whole. And in this text, I want to emphasize, in this video, I want to emphasize the chapter number 38.
And for this, we have to ask ourselves a few questions. Things are in outside the place, which you see here.
And that has to do with behavior. And I illustrate that with the pictures from the video. As you saw in the first part, of the video, the five dragons. These are the five dragon chi from the five different directions. We do a practice for like a breath practice to help you alter the way of your feelings and mind and the trend of your thoughts and so on. At the moment when you practice this, you feel gradually how you are replacing your negative thoughts and your negative behaviors with more positive ones, and as a result of that, you grow as a person. Hey mouse, how are you doing? My cat is appearing.
These things are in outside the place, which you see here.
What actually does, and is what all Tao Yin and Tuna breaths do within a Taoist context, it tries to help you to ritualize your life. And I have translated specially for the occasion the text number 38 of the Tao Te Ching to make sure. The five dragons are basically representing the Wuda, and Wuda is the basic five qualities of being. And Zhang Shan Fen talked about this, of course, Confucius talked about it. Lao Tzu mentions them as Tao, De, decency, humaneness, and rights. At the moment when we practice, then as such, we are ritualists. And it's the ritualist aspect of your training that actually has to help you get further in your progress of seeking Tao. And this is something that, of course, in modern Qigong and training of Tai Chi Chuan and Neidam very often is not understood. Ooh, my cat is trying to eat my knee. It's very often not understood because the most of the people, they try to see it in a sort of pseudo-scientific way by translating things like qi as energy and so on, and they try to make it into a mechanical process devoid of its natural purpose.
That's inside the temple. There is a very interesting statue from the Doma. It's actually an altar with Lao Jun in the middle, the Junwu old form on the left, and then on the right side there is a Doma, the goddess of time, sitting on a sheep, and then below her a turtle. Amazing statue. I completely forgot about it because I've only seen it one time, and the last time I was here the temple was just closing, so I could only see it a short time. But what I do remember is here the painting of Lao Jun. This painting
at the moment
when
you
famous.
Undo something from its actual purpose, of course it becomes something else, and they try to fit it through that into sort of a biological model where maybe in a spiritualized way you can enhance or alter your physical structures as if that is separate from who you are as a person. What Taoism actually says is like, look, you are a person, you are part of the world, and you are part of Tao, and therefore the five Tao, they follow out of each other. You can say that they are like a circle. In a sense, you first have Tao that creates De. The De creates decency, because when you are De, you are also decent. You behave decently. You behave in the right way as things are supposed to be done. Then at that moment, when you are decent, you're supposed to also be humane. That means you have to have compassion for your fellow beings. And not only the human beings, but also the animals and the plants and the demons and the ghosts and the gods and the insects and the, you know, whatever else there is out there. And the last one, of course, is because of your humaneness, you can also properly act, which is ritualized acting, because this ritualized acting is continuously reinforcing Tao, reinforcing Te, reinforcing decency, reinforcing humaneness, reinforcing the ritual itself, so that you become better at it and come to a deeper understanding. This is what Tao Te Ching, tongue number 38 is all about. And also in the Patreon post, the text in Chinese, pinyin, and in translation is there so that you can correct me if I make a mistake. Lao Tzu in himself was a person, a historian, and people liked him because of that, because they saw him as a wise person. He didn't agree, obviously, with his government, so he left the country that he was from. And you see this also in modern countries, that people don't agree with their governments, and as a result of that they leave. On the other hand, the world is getting smaller and smaller, so wherever you go to, eventually you will run into a place where you can't agree with, and then you're stuck with the same thing. So running away doesn't really work, and Lao Tzu could that do in his time. In our time, running away is not a responsible thing. You have to work on changing your country in a way, and changing the world in a way which is in accord with Tao. And that means you have to come to understand things, and for this you have to ritually act so that you eventually gradually come to an understanding as the ancients used to understand. This is what Lao Tzu actually says. In the ancient times people understood that, and because of their ritualization they learned why it was like that, and our modern values in that sense should be rooted in the same thing. The story is, though, that Lao Tzu in itself is just an emanation of Lao Zhong. Lao Zhong, the god of creation, the god of Tao De and morality, the morality of existence, which is comprised of Tao and De. And Tao is that what is creating, and not like the god, but like a sort of a filter to which creation is taking place in different layers. And as a result of that, it gradually becomes, well, whatever you see around you. And at the moment when that has happened, then at that moment, the is inherent to the things. So if you look at anything...
Here's the backcourt for the monks, but there's nobody living here except the caretaker woman and her husband, who was trying to avoid that I make pictures of everything. And you can see some of the beautiful things. And it's a pity that this one is not restorated like the rest, because the main course of tourists probably doesn't come here.
And at the moment when that has happened, then at that moment, the is inherent, like my good sin here, you see that this thing in itself, you know, it is a thing with inherent qualities. These qualities teach me, let me play the instruments because of my inherent qualities. And it means that the qualities of me and the things around me, they all support each other. And then if Tao is good at work, then all does, they support each other. And that means that we all grow together because of each other. That is called Lao Jun, or how he is called, Taishang Lao Jun Tian Tsung, is one of three gods. These three gods are associated with the Dan Tian after the three worms of your body have been eradicated. And the three worms, to eradicate them, that is actually pretty tough stuff. You have to do a lot of things to get rid of it, and it takes several years. Every worm is intended to destroy you, and as a result of that you will die if you do not destroy them. So they are the main reason why we age and grow older. The Lao Jun is part of three gods, of which Taishang Lingbao Tianzun and Taishang Taiyi Tianzun are the two other parts. And they basically, when you are not ready, are not inside you, but as a ritualist you gradually learn after you eradicate the worms and after you have done the dragon breath practices and so on, another set, few sets of practices that are related to the Zhongwuzhigong practice that we do. With these practices then gradually you integrate the three gods inside your body, and with them you take their generals, their soldiers, their wives, and you take basically a connection where you lift yourself up towards the high court, through which you eventually become an influential ritualist. Your Tao and Te both are going to become basically upgraded. The Lao Jun is part of three gods, of which Taishang, Lingbao, Tianzun, and Taishang, Taiyi, Tianzun are the two other parts. And they basically, when you are not ready, are not inside you, but as a ritualist, you gradually learn after you eradicate the worms and after you have done the dragon breath practices and so on, another set. Few sets of practices that are related to the Zhongzhikong practice that we do. With these practices, then gradually you integrate the three gods inside your body, and with them you take their generals, their soldiers, their wives, and you take basically a connection where you lift yourself up towards the high court, through which you eventually become an influential ritualist.
One of the beautiful things about this Lao Jun statue is that it really sits on a blue azure cloud, and that of course is quite unique in its own right. There's no puppy anymore here, so it was clearly calling me. That was really very nice of the puppy. Thank you, puppy.
Yeah.
How long do I stand here?